Yeah. check, 1-2. Mic check, 1-2.
Hello and welcome to Bullis Field Hockey on this hot Friday afternoon where the Bullis Bulldogs are facing off against the Brookewood Tigers. And tonight is a very special game. It is senior night, so we will be having the senior ceremonies, which include Coach Duffy doing the ceremony and the national anthem. So in about 5 minutes, the senior ceremony will take place, and stay tuned because that will be happening also on the live stream.
welcome to Klein Alumni Stadium. Today, our Bulldogs will take on the Brookewood Bengals. Before today's event, we'd like to honor our seniors. First, double zero, the goalkeeper, Maeve Zimmer. Maeve began at Bullis in the third grade and has been on the varsity field hockey team for 4 years. While she is currently undecided for college, she knows that she plans on studying engineering or data analytics. In her career at Bullis, she has enjoyed seeing the team develop throughout the season, both on the field, skill-wise, and grow closer off the field. Her best moment in her career was defeating Holy Child and how well the team worked well together to improve every day. While at Bullis, Maeve was also involved as the co-head of BST Upper School. She was a peer mentor and was involved with international internship with Nigeria with a focus on public health. Coach Zillette said Maeve is going to leave a huge hole in our program. She has been our solid wall in the cage for the past 4 years. Every single one of her teammates trust her back there, which has allowed us to take risks on the field, knowing she has the team covered. Maeve is a scholar of the game, and we have all seen the beneficiaries of her knowledge of the sport. Congratulations to Maeve and her family. Next, defense person, Sarah Margoo. Sarah began at Bullis as a freshman and has been on the varsity field hockey team for 3 years. While she is currently undecided for college, she plans on studying pre-law to pursue a career in criminal defense and international civil rights. While at Bullis, Sarah enjoyed getting to know the community better through sports, and she loved how we all supported each other like sisters and are always there for one another. She will miss doing sprints across the field and barking in practice. Sarah was very involved in the Bullis community. She was a member of the Bullis Student Tutors, the Conduct Review Board, leader of Teens with Heart Songs, member of the Community Service Team, member of the National Honor Society, a volunteer for the NGO, and part of the International Law and Advocacy Internship through nonprofit leadership initiatives. Her advice to her teammates is to cherish all the memories, even the bad ones, because one day you will look back and laugh about it all. Coach Zillette says, Sarah is the energizer bunny of our team. She always brings the fun to drills, but also knows when it's time to get serious. She is a scrappy defensive player, and I have loved seeing the culmination of the improvement to her skills this season. She has gotten better every season and plays with finesse now. Congratulations to Sarah and her family. Number 13, forward Lindsay Smith. Lindsay started at Bullis in the ninth grade and has played all 4 years of her high school career on the varsity team. While she has not decided on where to attend college, she's planning on studying industrial engineering. She has really enjoyed the excitement felt
by the whole school on game days and the genuine interest that her teammates have for each other. She is most proud of starting her first varsity game as a junior in the first game of the year. While at Bullis, Lindsay was also a Bullis student tutor, member of the National Honor Society, involved with Women in STEM Club, and on the Bullis diving team as well. Her advice to her teammates is to always have a good attitude about playing because it helps the team dynamic, and enjoy the time you have playing because it goes by so fast and this is one of the last times you'll be with the people around you. Coach Zillette says, Lindsay is a team player on and off the field. She is one of the most coachable players we have. She's worked hard with and is always asking questions about positioning and skills. She not only pushes herself every day to do her best, but she also pushes her teammates to do well. She is such a joy to work with. Congrats to Lindsay and her family. Number 14, defense person, Ellie Herr. Ellie began attending Bullis in the ninth grade and has played all 4 years on the varsity field hockey team. She has not decided where she would like to attend college.
Yeah.
Ellie has most enjoyed the fun times at practice with all her friends and added that it was nice to have a sport to go to after a long day in the classroom. She will always miss playing field hockey and being able to do it with her friends. Her best memories will be starting in her sophomore year and defeating Holy Child this season. While at Bullis, she was a part of the varsity lacrosse team, Women in STEM Club, Science National Honor Society, and a part of the Bullis Student Tutors. Her advice to all her teammates, enjoy all the time you have playing at Bullis because it goes by much faster than you think. Have fun at all the practices and games. Coach Zillette says, I know Ellie was surprised, do we have a better word for this, when she was moved to defensive player last year. But I hope she sees now that it is where she belongs. She comes up with big stops and then has the ball handling skills and passing technique to get the ball up the field. They say the offensive plays start with the defense. And on our team, we have Ellie to thank for that. Congratulations to Ellie and her family. Number 17, defense person, Sophia Benign. Sophia started at Bullis in the seventh grade and has played 2 years on the varsity field hockey team. While she has not chosen a college to attend, she plans on studying pre-law. She really loves how close she and her teammates were on and off the field. It made going to practice and games so much more enjoyable. She's also going to miss the community in addition to the Bullis field hockey team. Her proudest moment as a Bullis field hockey player was when they defeated Holy Child. Sophia was president of Booster Club and involved with the Colon Cancer Alliance. Her advice to her teammates would be to keep the amazing atmosphere and team bonding because it changes the entire experience of being on the field hockey team. Coach Zillette said, Sophia comes to practice every day ready to work hard and with a big smile on her face. She is a true team sport athlete, and I think everyone of her teammates can attest to the fact that she cares deeply for each and every one of them. I am so glad that Sophia decided to play last year. Her love for her teammates shines through unwaveringly. Congratulations to Sophia and her family. Number 22, midfielder Sydney Anzalone. Sydney started at Bullis in the sixth grade and has been a part of the varsity field hockey team for 4 years. She will play lacrosse at Hamilton College and looks to study psychology. In her career, she is so grateful for all of the great friendships she made. She will also miss all of our hype game days and my amazing teammates and coaches. She is most proud of the way this year's team has grown and come together as a huge threat in the ISL. While at Bullis, she was also a Bullis varsity lacrosse player and part of the National Honor Society. As I graduate, she says, my advice to the rest of the team is to cherish each second you get on the field in a Bullis jersey and to always stay true and hungry to your truths. Coach Zillette said, Sydney has emerged as an incredible leader this year. It has been exciting to see her come out of her shell over her seasons as a middle school and high school player. She has been an impact player for years, but in particular this season. She has risen to the occasion of offensive center mid and corner hitter. There is no question The strength of Sydney's offensive prowess is what keeps us going. Congratulations to Sydney and her family. Number 24, midfielder Olivia Keel. Olivia started at Bullis in the ninth grade and has been a varsity field hockey player all 4 years. She has committed to the University of Maryland for lacrosse and will study business. In her Bullis career, she has loved the team atmosphere and how much fun everyone has together. We can be serious, but always have fun, and everyone is friends with each other, is what Olivia said. Her proudest team accomplishment was beating St. Stephen St. Agnes during her freshman season. She was also on the varsity lacrosse team and a member of the Booster Club. Her advice to her teammates, enjoy every moment. It goes by very fast. Cherish the time you have with your teammates. Coach Zolette says, Olivia has given her whole heart to this program. Even last year, sidelined with a knee injury, she gave it her all while not even playing. We are so thrilled to have her back on the field this year, and she has played like never before. She is the core of our lineup, holding the shape of the whole team as the defensive center mid. She holds herself and her teammates to high standards and demonstrates all of this to give 110% of herself to the sport. Congratulations to Olivia and her family. Let's give one more round of applause for this year's field hockey seniors.
Thank you. my stomach coming out.
Time, would you please rise and remove all your headgear for the singing of the national anthem?
Welcome back to Bullis Field Hockey after the special senior night celebrations where Bullis is taking on the Brookewood Bengals. And this should be a good one. Last time field hockey played, we saw Sydney Anzalone have a big day, along with Olivia Keel and Sina Nyache. So they are looking for more of the same if they want to stay strong heading into ISL play as the Bulldogs take the field. We'll see Kendall Crawford along with Sydney Anzalone up top for the Dogs. And here come the Brookewood Bengals looking to upset the Bulldogs on senior night. So the Bengals will start with the ball. And they'll play it back. So Anna Brown gets it to McHale. But the Bulldogs take over. And they're going down the sidelines. Here's Lindsay Smith looking for a cross into the box. And they'll play it back to Olivia Keel. Gets it to Anzalone. Anzalone back to Keel. But the pass is intercepted, and a good job by this Bengals defense. However, a whistle is blown. And the Bulldogs take over again. Keel needs a cross. Cuts back in. As both teams are fighting for the ball, and the Bengals clear. But right back to the Bulldogs. We're looking for a way to get it right back into the box. Here's Crawford. And she loses it. We'll see who it's out on. Looks like it will be a free hit for the Bulldogs. Keel will take it. As they're facing their real first opportunity of the game. And here comes Jenkins. Jenkins cutting down the sideline, but right to the Bengals. And right back to Keel. Keel working her way in. Clears it into the box. Smith running after it. Both teams are fighting for possession, and the shot hits the post. It's rattling around the box. Hole can't scoop it up for the Bengals. And the whistle is finally blown. And it looks like it will be a penalty corner for the Bulldogs. So a big break for them. So they're looking to line up Anzalone and Keel on that left side. That's probably who they're going to want to get the ball to. So here's the corner. They get it to Anzalone. Anzalone with a shot into the box. And it goes out of bounds, and it looks like it will still be the Bulldogs' possession. Free hit coming up for them. As we've seen, Hull not be able to make some saves right in front of her led to some deflections. And another free hit for the Bulldogs. This will be a penalty corner again. This time it goes to Keel. Keel back to Anzalone. Anzalone's shot came in high and fast. And a whistle was blown as it deflected off of the Bengal player. And the coach runs on the field to see if they are okay. Looks like it might have hit her in the face, head area. That's always scary to see. You never want to see that. And she will be walked off the field. She looks to be okay. That's always a good sign. But a strong start for this Bulldogs offense. They've controlled possession of the ball. They've really had it near the Bengals box pretty much the entire start to the game. So it will be a free hit for the Bengals. And they play it right back to the Bulldogs. The Bulldogs now have numbers. They pass it to Nyache. Nyache cross into the middle. Both teams are fighting for it, and it looks like the whistle will be blown, and it will be a free hit going the other way for the Bengals. And that was a really poor attempt, the first free hit, and they do it right again. They just kind of hit it right down the middle of the field, right back into the Bullets offense. And now Keel cutting right down the middle of the field. Ball back to Keel. She tries to play it down the sideline. A very strong hit there. They try to get the cross to Kendall Crawford as the ball rattles back out and the Bengals take possession. But they hand it right back over to the Bulldogs again. And here come the Bulldogs. Keel and a diving stop made. But the deflection is still a factor. As a great stop by Hull, but she was not able to scoop it up. As the Bengals look to get the ball up across midfield. Here comes Robluski. As the Bengals look to get something going on offense, but their defense has really not controlled the ball well. They kind of handed it right back over to the Bulldogs when they've had opportunities to clear it out of trouble. Keel has been there to get the majority of the deflections. As here comes Nyache down the near sideline. She tries to get it to Crawford. She does. Crawford now looking for an edge around the corner. She's shielding the ball with her body. Gets it out to Jenkins. Jenkins will cross it into the middle of the field. Keel comes up with it. Excuse me, Anzalone. So a free hit for the Bengals. And this time they play it smart. They get it out to the side. That's definitely what they should have done the first two times. So the Bulldogs will take over with the free hit, and they'll cut it right down the middle of the field to Keel. Keel on the run. She'll play it out to Nyache. Nyache looking for a cross into the box. She's bullying her way into the box. She might just do it herself. She plays it out to Jenkins, and the whistle is blown. The whistle will be on the Bulldogs. And another free hit. This time the Bulldogs will take over. They get it again to Nyache. She's really been the go-to when looking for opportunities down the sideline. It's been Keel and Nyache running the offense for the Bulldogs early on. So the Bengals will have the free hit. But they'll give it right back to the Bulldogs. As Keel is there to make the stop and some fancy stick work by her to get it to Anzalone. Now Jenkins, great pass to Anzalone. Anzalone whiffs the shot. And with the second chance, she knocks it out of bounds. So a lucky break there for Brookewood as the Bulldogs had opportunities very close to the goal and they were not able to put one in the back of the net. So, both teams heading to their respective sidelines. As the clock is stopped right now, so we don't know exactly how much time has expired. I imagine that is the end of the first quarter. It has been all Bulldogs all the time, as they've had plenty of opportunities to get the go-ahead goal, but they have not been able to do it. Their offense has looked strong, and their defense really has not been tested, as the Bengals have not been able to really get the ball past midfield so far. Bengals try to clear, they give it right back to Keel.
That's it, nice play. Upfield. Oh, oh, no way. Oh, no way. Come on, Blue, stay with it. Come on, Blue.
So now Bullis trying to control possession down the sidelines. Give it to Keel. Keel gets it out to Jenkins. Jenkins with a nice ball down the sidelines. To Rumsfeld. But the ball will go out of bounds, and a good job by that Bengal defense to knock it out of trouble. Good job there by Jenkins to take control. Out to Rumsfeld, and now the ball is rattling around in the corner and it will go out of bounds. Will be Bengals ball. Bullis looking for another opportunity as the ball narrowly goes out of bounds, as that was in the box for a long time. Bulldogs take over again, as this offense has played well transitioning. They've been able to intercept a lot of passes as Angelo now gets the cross into the box. No one home. As the ball goes all the way to the opposite corner. And now Angelo looking for an opportunity, but Burksfield will take it the other way. But they give it right back to the Bulldogs, as both teams' possession has been very fluid early on. Brooksfield, a very young team. They only have one senior and just a handful of juniors. The majority of the team are underclassmen. They're looking to upset a very tough Bullis field hockey team early on. Bullis now, they're putting Brooksfield in a position where, you know, if they intercept one pass, they're already so far down the field, as that shot was an absolute bullet and a good save made by Hooley. As Bullis have, they've been able to get a couple of good shots off, but Hooley has made some nice saves early on. So that was a bullet by Olivia Keel. Bullis trying to get the ball into the middle. That pass is intercepted by McHale. Right back to the Bulldogs now as Angelo takes over. Whistle is blown. And a penalty corner coming up for the Bulldogs. Let's see if they can make the most of it. They went to Angelo the first time and Keel the second time. We'll see what they do here on the third penalty corner of the game for the Bulldogs. They play it out to Angelo. That shot just misses, as that was dangerously close to sneaking into the bottom right part of the goal there. But a lucky break for the Bengals, as it will be a free hit for them going the other way instead. Bullis attacking now. Here's Rumsfeld spinning her way into the box. And that ball will go out of bounds. It will be Bulldogs ball as Brill will take it for the Bulldogs. Nice pass threading the needle there to Rumsfeld. Rumsfeld crosses it into the box. Both teams fighting for possession. The pass to Anzalone. Anzalone's shot is good. Sydney Anzalone scores the first goal of the day for the Bulldogs as they take a 1-0 lead. With just a minute 41 left in the first quarter. What a shot by the senior to put the Bulldogs ahead early on. And that was a really nice job there by Macy Brill, the freshman, to create the offense. And she crossed it into the box to Anzalone, who was able to put it into the back of the net. Bullis now threatening again. It's Smith down the sideline. As both teams have been a little sloppy with the ball early on. And a long pass there for the Bulldogs, getting it out to Brill down the near sideline. But the ball goes out of bounds, and it will be a free hit for the Bengals, going the other way. Pulhas will take it, but looks like the whistle was blown. Looks like there is some confusion going on right now. I think it is with the clock of the scoreboard. So here's Pulhas, and she gives it right back to the Bulldogs, and a great play by Kendall Crawford to get past the defender. She's now working her way down the sidelines, looking for a way into the box. And it looks like she was bumped there, so she gets the free hit. Her cross does not make it into the box. It is intercepted, but right back to Anzalone. Anzalone gets it out to Keel. 40 seconds left, and that shot is wide. As we get down to the final seconds of the first quarter. Bullis sideline starting some chants. In what has been a very low scoring game compared to previous Bullis field hockey games, the offense has had opportunities. And it looks like Bullis now have an opportunity, but just 5 seconds left. And that will do it here at Klein Alumni Stadium for the first period of action, first quarter of action. We have Bulldogs 1, Brookewood Bengals 0. So we're getting ready and geared up for the second quarter of action coming up shortly. And we are back for the second quarter of action at Klein Alumni Stadium. Bullis Bulldogs 1, Brookewood Bengals 0. As the Bengals will start with the ball. We'll see if they're able to muster up any offense early on. They really were not in the first quarter. And here come the Bulldogs as Rumsfeld down the sideline. Gets by her defender. And the ball will go out of bounds. We'll see who it's on. Looks like the Bengals will take possession. Or not. Okay, so an opportunity for the Bulldogs. As the ball is rattling around in the box. Hull had to come down to her knees to make the save, but it looks like it will be another opportunity for the Bulldogs. Looks like a penalty corner. They play it short. The cross was fired into the box. Keel digs it out. She gets it to Rumsfeld. The deflection, the shot again by Rumsfeld. Hooley comes in, makes the save. We'll see if the ball went out of bounds. It looks like it will be a clean save off of Hooley. So a free hit for the Bulldogs coming up. They get it to Rumsfeld down the sideline. She cuts in. She crosses it into the middle. The deflection. And the Bulldogs were not able to put it in. As Hooley has played pretty well early on in goal. He's had to make a couple of nice saves. But the Bulldogs will have another penalty corner. They get it directly to Rumsfeld. Rumsfeld fires. Ball bouncing high up there. And it will be going the other way. The Bengals will take over. We'll see if they're able to get the free hit out into the sidelines or if they're just going to give it right directly back to the Bulldogs. That's a nice play by Brill to get it back to the Bulldogs as Rumsfeld cutting in. Her shot is on target but is deflected. And we'll see who it is out last on. It looks like the Bengals will take possession. So a good stop there by Hooley. And Rumsfeld is right there to make another play. She's played well early on. As we're kicking off what should be a fantastic sports weekend. We have a full slate of NFL games. We have MLB playoffs coming up. So really exciting time to be a sports fan. You can start it right here with Bullis Girls Field Hockey. So here comes Keel. Her shot is snatched right out of her stick by Brown. Nice play there. As here comes Rumsfeld again down the sidelines. Her cross is rattling around in the box. Smith is there, gets it out. Rooley is on her head right now, making some fantastic saves. As Keel fires it back into the box for the Bulldogs, right back to Rumsfeld. Rumsfeld looking for a cross, and the whistle is finally blown. And another penalty corner coming up for the Bulldogs. Anzalone is there on the right side. I think that's probably who they play it to. It is. Anzalone's shot is good. Second goal of the game for Sydney Anzalone to make it 2-0 with just over 10 minutes to play in the first half. And she's putting on a performance here at Klein Alumni Stadium. And both of Sydney Anzalone's goals early on have been kind of long-range snipes, you know. She hasn't really had to work her way through too many defenders. She's just kind of put it in a corner from afar, that time on the penalty corner. And I could see her scoring a couple more. Still plenty of time to play. A free hit by Pohas. Pohas gives it right back to the Bulldogs. A nice pass there by Keel to get it out to Jenkins. Jenkins gives it up. So another opportunity for the Bulldogs early on as this penalty corner is coming up. Smith will take it. Just over 9 minutes to play in the first half. Bullis 3, Brookewood 0. As here's the penalty corner. Anzalone, her shot is deflected right back to the Bulldogs. And Hooley with a nice save. Ball still rattling around in there. Hooley is not able to come up with it. And the whistle is finally blown. And another penalty corner coming up for Bullis. As the Brookewood defense have not been able to clear the ball out of the box when they've been in trouble. Repeat that. They play it to Keel. Keel sets, fires. And it is good, a goal for Olivia Keel to make it 3-0 Bulldogs. Off the penalty corner, she just fired it low into the box. There might have been a deflection, there might have been a tip, but nevertheless, another goal for the Bulldogs as they're looking to continue their utter dominance of the Brookewood Bengals early on in the first half. So Bullis threatening yet again. So they're looking to thread the ball back into the box. And the whistle is blown. Yet another penalty corner for the Bulldogs. Smith will take it again. She's been really good at those so far, getting the ball to either Anzalone or Keel. Anzalone at the top of the key. Deflected, but right picked up by Keel. Keel's shot is deflected right out of the air by Hull. Howe just plucked it there. That was a nice shot by Keel, as the Bengals will have the free hit. Looks like that might have been handball or just a little bit high. So Anzalone will take the free hit from very dangerous territory. I could see her, you know, she plays it back to Keel. Might have been able to get a shot off there. Keel splits the defenders. What a move. Works her way into the middle. Still going. Finally loses the ball about a couple feet from the goal. Crosses it in there. Bengals finally with another free hit. They get it out to McHale. McHale loses it. Gives it right back to the Bulldogs. Here's Rouse. Checked into the game for the Bulldogs. Hughes gets it out to Sophia Bename. Bename tries to get it to her. Looks like she does. And a nice job there by this Bengals defense. But they give it right back to the Bulldogs as we enter the final 5 minutes of the first half. Here's Anzalone. Gets it to Keel. Those two have been the dynamic duo all game. Hughes in the corner loses possession. And the Bengals will take over. What a mistake there by Armstrong. She just whiffed on the free hit. Morford is there, but can't make the play for the Bulldogs. So Anzalone gets it out into the corner to Morford. Morford looking for a cross. Keel will take the free hit for the Bulldogs. 3 minutes 15 seconds to play in the first half. Bullis 3, Brookewood 0. Benay makes a nice stop there. She's working her way upfield. And she'll give the free hit to Hughes, so Hughes will take it now. Gets it to Anzalone. Anzalone crosses it to Keel. Keel cannot keep possession. So the Bengals will have the free hit. They're going to have to muster up some offense if they want to stay in this one. They only have 2 minutes to do it in the first half. They're trying to cut down their deficit. Hughes chasing after it. She won't get there. So the Bengals will have the free hit going the other way. She misses the free hit again. We've seen that a couple times. It kind of scoops it. Whistle will be blowed on that play. Anzalone will take the free hit. She crosses it all the way across the field. An opportunity for the Bulldogs now as the ball is in dangerous territory for the Bengals. Hughes takes right over for the Bulldogs. Anzalone fires the cross in. No one there. Smith can't handle it as that will go out of bounds. As we are in the final minute of the first half, Bull is still leading 3-0. And what a shot there. What an absolute bullet by Olivia Keel for her second goal of the game in the final seconds of the first half. I mean, that just came out of nowhere. Off of the penalty corner. Looked like she was looking for a cross, but she just hooked that stick and put it into the back of the net to make it 4-0 Bulldogs. So, we're under 15 seconds. Benay with a nice defensive play made there. But it looks like it will be a free hit for Pohas. Pohas now scoops it right into the heart of the Bulldog defense. And that will do it for the first half of action here at Klein Alumni Stadium. Bullets ahead 4-0 and what has really just been a total domination. Their defense has not really been tested. Their offense has played great, and we will be back for the second half of action. Welcome back to the second half of action here at Klein Alumni Stadium. Bullis got out to an early lead and has kept it so far as they are up 4-0 against the Brookewood Bengals. And they're looking to continue to roll in the second half. We got two more periods to go. The Bulldogs will start with the ball. Here comes Niache. She loses it down the sideline. Looks like that will be a free hit for the Bengals. And a nice job there by Keel to intercept it, or Anzalone. Keel chipping it into the box. Just under the stick of Niache. She would have had an opportunity if she was able to handle it. As here's Ellie Herr. She plays it deep to Niache. Niache looking for the cross. Ball will go out of bounds. It will be a free hit for the Bulldogs. Back to Herr. Herr, strong shot to Keel, but it will be heading the other way. A whiff there, the second try they get it. Sometimes it takes two. And here come the Bulldogs. This is Bengals defense looking pretty strong in the second half as Anzalone whiffs there and the ball will be heading the opposite direction. Smith juggling the ball. Impressive display there. Looks like she used the wrong side of the stick. So Brown with the ball now. Intercepted by Anzalone. Anzalone down the sidelines, but looks like the ball, she knocked it out of bounds. Back to Keel. Keel gets it out to Jenkins in open space. Gets it to Niache. Niache crosses it into the box. Keel just intercepted it there. right out to Anzalone. Anzalone looking for her third goal of the day. Both her and Keel have two goals, two apiece for the Bulldogs. Keel intercepts it there. The pass to Niace. Niace with the shot. And an empty net, a goal for Lindsay Smith. Put the Bulldogs ahead 5-0. That was a really nice job by Keel. She got it out to Niace. And Niace could have shot as Margot Cole, the goalie for the Bengals, was diving to make the save. But she went with that extra pass to Smith, who was wide open, a foot from the net. One of the easiest goals he will ever score. And she put it into the back of the net to bring the score up to 5-0. And Keel splits the defender. She's across midfield with a head of steam. And she loses the ball. Armstrong with a nice play there. A loud cheering section for Lucy Armstrong, the junior from Brookewood. Bullis with an opportunity. Butcher was there. She was not able to handle it. She recovers, though. She gets it out to Ellie Herr. Herr loses it. And here comes Rabluski. Rabluski trying to get it up past midfield. She gets it over to Searby. But that pass is broken up by Margoob, and now here comes Smith. She is tripped up. The whistle will be blown, and that will be a free hit for the Bulldogs deep into Bengal territory. Anzalone will take it. She'll get it out to Butcher. Butcher to Keel. Keel at the top of the key gets by her defender. Low shot deflected back out to Herr. Herr will chip it up to Keel into the box. Saved by Hooley. That shot was close, but just snuck around that left post to go out of bounds. Looks like that was a high stick. Or offsides. So Keel has a free hit from the top of the key. I wonder if she just takes a shot. She'll play it back. Ball rattling around in the box. Whistle is blown. A free hit for the Bengals. And here comes Brookswood down the sideline. They'll have another free hit. Brown will take it. She'll have another one. She'll just play it up herself. She gets it to McHale. McHale, dangerous territory. Nice job there by Bename to clear. And she'll get out of danger. Preserving the shutout for the Bulldogs. Bullets now. With a full head of steam. And a pass out wide to Rouse. Rouse with the cross. And she goes down hard. She missed the shot. Could not keep her footing. And went down to the turf. We've seen a lot of whiffs here today. Brookewood whiffs again. Here comes Keel. Crosses into the middle. Ball deflects out of bounds. And a penalty corner coming up for the Bulldogs. You see if they give it to Keel. Might try to give it to her, you know, senior night, and they do. They give it to her. Her lofts it into the box. I mean, if we're being honest here, that's just a tremendous call by me. I mean, come on. I'm reading the plays before it's even happening. And here comes Brookewood trying to cross it up across midfield. Whistle is blown. It will be a free hit going the other way for the Bulldogs. Herb will take it. 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. Bulls 5, Brookewood 0. Nice pass by her. And that shot, what a mistake! I mean, how did that not cross midline? That shot, that was unbelievable. Butcher with sort of a soft shot that she kind of just lofted up into the box, you know, hoping to connect with a teammate. And Margot Hull, it got through her legs and she dove on it and was somehow, I don't know how, able to keep it from crossing the midline as Anzalone shot there. Deflected back out to her. Saved by Hooley. Cross there. Finds Butcher. Butcher's shot is tipped in and is good. Although the call, the goal will be blown dead. Good call by the ref there. So no goal. And that pass is right to Altman. Dangerous pass there for Brookewood. Her now working her way up across midfield. Good pass out to Keel. Keel working downhill. The shot is saved. And here come the Bulldogs, and a sliding save by Hooley. Just seconds to play in the third quarter. Free hit for Brookewood. Looks like a whistle is blown, so we're in the final 30 seconds. Bullets will have a free hit. About 20 yards or so from the goal. They get it out to Anzalone. Anzalone going for the hat trick. But that is an easy save for Hooley. Back to Anzalone. That shot is much harder and a tough save made by Hooley again. And that will do it for the third quarter of action at Klein Alumni Stadium. Bullets 5. Brookewood Bengals 0. Brookewood is going to have to get something going fast if they want any chance to stay in this one. And we will see you guys for an exciting fourth quarter coming up. And we are back for the fourth quarter of action at Klein Alumni Stadium. Bullets leading 5-0, looking to add to their lead. They might look to get a couple of extra seniors some goals tonight. So we have 15 minutes to go in this one. Bulldogs will start with the ball. Play to Anzalone. And the whistle will be blown. Bulls takes over. They'll get it to her. Her right around midfield. Nice hesitation move, and she'll get it out. Down to the sideline. You know, the sun has been covered. It's cooled down, you know, considerably in this one. It was very hot in the first quarter. Now there's a nice breeze in the 60s. It's beautiful weather. As Pujas will take the free hit. Excuse me, Brown. So here come the Bengals. They're now looking to have something going as they're getting deeper into Bulldog territory. But they give it right back to Angelone. Fires it right back to them. But a nice play by Morford to take over. And here come the Bulldogs again. Here's Keel. The shot is off the post. Good shot there by Keel. She went the length of the field. Just under 13 minutes to go. Bullis 5, Brookewood 0. Bengals will have a free hit. They give it right back to the Bulldogs. Here come the Bulldogs. Keel making plays all over the field. But the whistle is blown and it will be going the other way. Here come the Bulldogs, the cross, a nice kick save by Hooley. Kick save and a beauty. And here comes the penalty corner for the Bulldogs. They get it to Anzalone. Anzalone sets, passes it back. Ball is rattling around in the box. Both teams trying to get a hold of it. Right in front of the goal. Anzalone shot just wide. What an opportunity for the Bulldogs. They're not able to net it there. But they will take over and have a free hit. Here's her. Gets by her defender. Nice pass to Anzalone. He was on her back making save after save. Her takes over. And the whistle is blown. It will be heading the other way. Ten minutes to go now. Here comes Smith down the sideline. She cuts into the middle of the field, but whistle is blown. So it will be a free hit for Brookewood. Arnold in the game for the Bulldogs. Looks like whistle is blown again. Free hit coming up. Here comes Anzalone cutting into the middle of the field. She can't get a good shot off as that pass is intercepted. And here comes Searby. She loses it right back to the Bulldogs. And right back to the Bengals now. But Naeem has made a couple of really key plays for the Bulldogs defensively. Eight and a half minutes to go. Bullets 5, Brookewood 0. Here's her. She'll get it out to Arnold. Arnold now, the freshman, working her way downfield. A nice pass there, just a little too strong, looking for Keel. Can Keel take over, though? She can, as the Bulldogs will have a free hit coming up. So, a penalty corner coming up for the Bulldogs. They get it to Keel. Keel sets, fires, and is blocked by the Bengal defense. They get it back, though. And she shoots again. Knocked down and out of bounds as the Bengals will take it the other way. Looks like we have an injury on the field. You never want to see that. Under 7 to go. Bulldogs threatening yet again. Intercepted by Anzalone. She's working her way down the sideline. And to add to their 5-0 lead. Cross into the middle. Keel is there. Bodying her way past the defenders. And that shot is good. Looks like it deflected off the foot of a Bulldog player after Keel shot it. But what a game for Olivia Keel and also Sydney Anzalone has. When those two are playing well, you know it's going to be a good day for that Bullis offense. So they're leading 6-0 with 5.5 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Here's Anzalone. Sideline whistle is blown. And here come the Bulldogs and Lindsey Smith leading the charge. Right back to Anzalone. She loses it though, and it's a free hit for the Bengals. So we're under 4 minutes to play. What a dominant game this has been for the Bulldogs. I mean, I don't think I've seen Maeve Zimmer, the goalie, have to be tested even once. And that's what makes this Bullets team so good is that, you know, Zimmer is such a good goalie, but she doesn't even need to, she doesn't have to make that many great saves because this Bullets team is so good that there's just not that many shots on her most games. Two and a half minutes to go. So here's a free hit for the Bulldogs in the last 2 minutes. They're looking to tack on to their 6-0 lead. Bullets pressuring yet again. Here's Brill. Nice job there by her. Work her way down the field. Looking for Smith in the corner. She gets it to her Smith now. We'll play it out to Ellie Hurd. So we're just under a minute to go. Smith. Bullis threatening again. Here comes her. She sets, delivers, but that shot does not make it past the clump of defenders. As we are entering the final seconds, I do not think they're going to get this free hit off. That's right in front of the goal. They're just going to let the clock wind down and expire, as that will do it here from Klein Alumni Stadium. Bullis 6, Brookewood 0, as Bullis gets the win on senior night. I'm Jack Foman, and we will see you guys next time for Bullis Field Hockey.